sword husks. We have killed all the keepers. Thus we can free Lady Valerica. But we want to finish up first these loose ends. Wish to find all the pages of St. Jude's notes. We feel kind of sorry for him. We do not want to leave him like that, eh? If we can help him, we will try. But it is going to prove to be quite a trick to find 10 pages. Right, we haven't been here. What is this place? We've already slain all the keepers. Hello?
The clouds, the sky, it's all wrong.
Yes, yes. Everything is wrong. Nothing is right. Hello?
No one ever escapes. There is no escape. Why
well,
would you try?
Well, if you're dead, there's no escape. Fortunately, we are not dead. Alright. One more page. Only 3 left. Only 3 more pages. We can do this, eh? Alright, we're back here. Let us meet your mother again, eh? Alright. We have broken the barrier. Lady Valerica.
You managed to destroy all 3 keepers? Very impressive.
Well, Zephyr truly is impressive. we are only jesting. Anyway, you are able to give us the scroll now, yes?
Yes. Please, follow me.
Oh, all right.
Watch for Durnefir. With the prison's barrier down, he's almost certain to investigate.
Uh-oh. Huh. All right. Well, we have faced dragons before. Do you have any pages here? Maybe you can help us with that. Mortal blobs. No pages, though. Oh well. We are happy for you, Serana. Come on. All right. Yes.
Wait. I hear something.
Oh. Whoa. All right. Let us call up some help. Yes. Hello. Whoa! Right. Whoa, you are very strong, eh? We do not believe that we caused a dent in him. Can we do? Firebrand, eh? Huh. Alright, not too bad. not great, but could be been worse. Oop. All right, you are pretty strong, eh? How come we are not damaging you too much, eh? Alright, let's call in some help, eh? Alright. You know what? Let's call in someone more powerful. Right. Right.
Do it.
Right, all right. We are doing well. Whoa.
Do it.
Thank you, my dear. Well, oh, oh, come on. Uh-oh. Usually they give us all. Where is your mother, eh?
Forgive my astonishment, but I never thought I'd witness the death of that dragon.
Ha ha ha. Well, Zephyr, well, it is Zephyr's calling to kill dragons. Anyway, what makes you say that, eh?
Volumes written on Durnavir alleged that he can't be slain by normal means.
Huh.
It appears they were mistaken.
Well, Zephyr does not like the sound of that.
The soul of a dragon is as resilient as its owner's scaly hide. It's possible that your killing blow has merely displaced Dimitri's physical form while he reconstitutes himself.
Reconstitutes. That's great. And just how long will that take, eh?
Minutes, hours, years. I can't even begin to guess. I suggest we don't wait around to find out.
Now, good suggestion.
The Elder Scroll, and you can be on your way.
All right. Where's Serada? Well, of course, she's in here.
What did you want?
The Elder Scroll, eh? We did it, Serada. The first of two Elder Scrolls. Yes. You can see that you are very excited. Anyway, any pages here from Saint Jube, Saint Jib, whoever he, his name is. Come on, it's time to go. Lady Valerica.
Now that you've retrieved the Elder Scroll, you should be on your way.
You are staying here then?
I have no choice. As I told you before, I'm a daughter of Cold Harbor. If I return to Tamriel, that increases Harkon's likelihood of bringing the Tyranny of the Sun to fruition.
Ah. Well, we will return for you when we can, yes? Once Harkon's threat is taken care of.
I appreciate your concern for me. But Serana is all that I care about. We must keep her safe at all costs. Remember that Harkon is not to be trusted. No matter what he promises, he'll deceive you in order to get what he wants. And promise me you'll keep my daughter safe. She's the only thing of value.
Do not worry. We will keep her safe, eh? Alright. In some ways, Lady Valerica reminds us of our mother, eh? The love for a mother to her children is... well, it is a strength that defies everything. We can appreciate that. Whoa! Alright, well, that was fast. Round two?
Stay your weapons. I would speak with you, Quanarin.
Huh. Zephyr was under the impression that you were dead, Dragon.
Cursed, not dead. Doomed to exist in this form for eternity. Trapped between Laas and Inok. Between life and death.
Huh. So... why are we speaking then, eh?
I believe in civility among seasoned warriors, and I find your ear worthy of my words.
Huh.
My claws have rendered the flesh of innumerable foes, but I have never once been felled on the field of battle. I therefore honor name you Quanarin. Or Vanquisher, in your tongue.
Well, Zephyr found you equally worthy, Durnevir. He has rarely fought a dragon so strong, eh?
Your words do me great honor. My desire to speak with you was born from the result of our battle, Quanarin. Oh. I merely wish to respectfully ask a favor of you.
Now Zephyr is really curious, eh? What kind of favor, eh?
For countless years I've roamed the Soul Cairn in unintended service to the Ideal Master.
Huh.
Before this, I roamed the skies above Tamriel. I desire to return there.
Huh. What is stopping you then, eh? Exactly.
I fear that my time here has taken its toll upon me. I share a bond with this dreaded place. If I ventured far from the Soul Cairn, my strength would begin to wane until I was no more.
And just how could Zephyr help you?
I will place my name with you and grant you the right to call my name from Tamriel.
Oh.
Do me this simple honor, and I will fight at your side as your Graze Mazen, your ally, and teach you my Thune.
Oh. So we will just call your name in Tamriel, yes? Nothing more?
Trivial in your mind, perhaps. For me, it would mean a great deal. I don't require an answer, Quanarin. Simply speak my name to the heavens when you feel the time is right.
Huh. Zephyr wishes to know how you ended up in the Soul Cairn, eh?
There was a time when I called Tamriel my home. But those days have long since passed. The Dova roamed the skies, vying for their small slices of territory that resulted in immense and ultimately fatal battles.
You were a part of all that then, eh?
I was. But unlike some of my brethren, I sought solutions outside the norm in order to maintain my superiority. I began to explore what the Dova call Elok Dilan, the ancient forbidden art that you call necromancy.
Huh. So you were a... you were a dragon necromancer. That is very interesting, eh? And so you sought the soil cairn for answers, yes?
The ideal masters assured me that my powers would be unmatched. Hey. That I could raise legions of the undead. In return, I was to serve them as a keeper until the death of the one who calls herself Valerica.
Then they did not tell you that she was immortal.
I discovered too late that the ideal masters favor deception over honor and had no intention of releasing me from my binding. They had control of my mind, but fortunately they couldn't possess my soul.
Well, is that why you are free now?
Free? No. I have been here too long, Quanarin. The Soul Cairn has become a part of what I am. I can never fully call Tamriel my home again, or I would surely perish.
Huh.
I only hope that you will allow me the precious moments of time there through your call.
All right. We will consider it, Dornevir. We can assure you that, eh? As long as you come and fight by our side, you will find yourself in Tamriel many times, eh? Huh. All right. So... time to return, eh? Zephyr still wishes to find the pages of St. Jib's journal or notes. We only have 3 left to find. But we do understand that we are pressed for time, but well, we really do want to help this poor soul. Hey, Arbok! Hey! We found your skull! Hey! You know, you look very cool. Oh! Khajiit guesses we have to go back and find his owner. Let's try to search. Where? Alright. Now perhaps... perhaps we can find at least Arvak's owner. Where we found Arvok, eh? If we can only remember where we found him. This place is so confusing. It is, if we recall correctly, yes, that is it. That was the place where the skull was placed. It had all those dead all around it, eh? So maybe... There he is. Right. At least Kaji thinks this is him. Hello?
Ah. You saved him.
Yes.
His soul is free. I can feel it. He's such a loyal beast. Here, I'll teach you how to call him to you.
Oh?
He'll help you get around and support to the place. But I'm sure he'd be much happier someplace sunnier. Goodbye, hero. Take good care of Arvak for me. Such a good horse.
Kajit will, eh? Thank you. Huh. Well, apparently it's also possible to still find peace within the Soul Cairn, eh? And we have a new spell. summon its apprentice level. So we can use this even if we don't have... Even if we don't have fancy and magic. Hello, Arvak. All right, this is awesome. Well. Perhaps another time, eh? We won't ride while our lady here walks. Anyway... Yes. We still have to find one more Elder Scroll, but at least, indeed, we are a step closer to hopefully an eventual victory, eh? All right, let's go. All right. We just spent an inordinate amount of time searching all over the Soil Cairn. But we have found most of the pages of St. Jib's notes. And this is the last one. Whoa! All right, we are taking that well. Oh. Glass dagger. Whoa! Very nice. Well, just truly a grueling task to go all over this place. But at least it is done, eh? St. Jib is not too far from here. Let's go back to him. There he is. We have actually not read all his notes. Perhaps we should do so, eh? We might not have the chance. Page one, eh? I am a hunter. I am a redeemer. I am Jib. The tale of my rise to glory begins in the ash wastes of Morrowind. I rode alone, weapon at my side and the burning wind stinging my face. My quest was arduous, but necessary to ensure the survival of the Dunmer people. A pestilence was creeping across the Ashlands. A menace with an insatiable hunger that plagued innocent travelers simply trying to get home. It was my self-sworn task to hunt them down one by one and drive them from the skies. Their fury knew no bounds, and their war cry resonated across the land. They were the notorious Cliff Racers, and they had to be destroyed. On a particularly hot day during Sun's Height, I was tracking what I called a lingerer, a Cliff Racer without a nest. He was a particularly feisty one too, leading me on a merry chase across almost 3 miles of ash dunes. I had managed to take a piece out of one of his wings in an earlier scuffle, so he couldn't maintain much of a climb. But he still had quite a bit of stamina left, and he was trying to make me tire of the chase. Almost 2 solid hours passed, and my silt Strider was tiring, but I could not give up. I'd sworn to eliminate the foul beast to the last, and I wasn't about to let it go. If I was going to stop the thing, I'd have to do it fast. I pulled my longbow from my back and knocked my last arrow. I took a deep breath and pulled, trying to keep the Cliff Racer in my sights. It was literally a long shot with the beast gaining distance. And the Silt Strider bouncing me around at full gallop. Finally, with a silent prayer, I released the string. The arrow sang to the air like a howling demon, and it sliced its way towards its target. Finally, just as it crested the tip of a faena, the arrow struck it in the midsection. It let out a horrible cry and fell out of sight. My cries of triumph were quickly stifled by the sound of over 100 wings. Rising from the foyer, there was an entire colony of Cliff Racers, and they were out for blood. The blasted thing had led me right to their nest and sacrificed itself with the intent of feeding me to its brood. It was a trap. The damn things had become much too clever. Knowing this was likely the end, I jumped down from the Silt Strider and hit the back of its leg with the flat of my glass blade. I wonder if the dagger I found was his, eh? There was no need for the innocent thing to die here today because of my stupidity. As the ash cloud cleared from being stirred up by its massive legs, the Cliff Racer brood approached. I held my sword high and prepared for the worst. The battle lasted 2 full days. I was beaten, clawed, beaten and knocked down more times than I care to remember. In the end, 76 Cliff Racers were slaughtered. I was knee-deep in their corpses and my blood on the verge of collapse. But I had survived. I smiled to the heavens and all went black. When I awoke, all I felt was my back on a cold stone floor. Every muscle in my body was on fire, and my vision was blurred. Slowly, I tried to climb to my feet. It took several agonizing minutes, but I finally managed to do it. As my eyes adjusted to the dim light of my new surroundings, I realized that I was standing before Lord Vivek himself. He was simply staring at me, floating above his throne and staring at me with his piercing eyes. When I began to prostrate myself as a sign of respect, he held up one of his hands, as if to say, it wasn't necessary. Was I dead? Was Lord Vivek pleased with me? Was he about to strike me down in anger for my somewhat sordid past? Suddenly, I understood everything. Suddenly, I realized that I was brought here for a reason. I should have died in those ash wastes. But Lord Vivek must have seen something inside me that he hadn't seen in millennia, and decided to spare me from my fate. Thus began my ascent to sainthood. Thus began the rise of Jeeb. Oh. What an amazing story. We are honored to have found it for him, eh? You are a hero, my friend. Hello, Jeeb.
You did it. You have all of my pages.
It took a while, but the fear has found all the pages of your book. It was an honor helping you, friend. Here, take them.
Finally. I never thought I'd see these again. These pages meant the world to me. Thank you.
So, now what, eh?
Now volume 2 begins. What else?
Oh, good. Enjoy yourself, my friend. The fear will be off then, eh?
Oh, wait a moment. Here, I want you to have these before you go.
Ah.
A pristine copy of my first volume. Only one in print, actually. And take this as well. Seeing as Saint Chip has ascended to pure spiritual form, I won't need it any longer.
Be well, my friend. We will treasure your gifts. All right. Apologies, Serana. That was a bit of a time-consuming task, but we feel it was worth it, eh? It's time to go back to Tamriel and do what needs to be done, eh? But first, well... You know what? We're going to... I'm going to do something, eh? Make sure that we can finish whatever we need to do here after all is said and done. The only thing is we need to find our way back to Lady Valerica's domicile. Less than nothing at this point, eh? Oh, shit. Ooh, nice. Heh. We will not fall to Rathmen. Especially when we can summon them ourselves, eh? This place, well... This place is not so terrible anymore. We are old hands at wandering this place, eh? It has actually become a bit familiar. And, to be honest, boring. So we should leave. Kaji thinks that we will be leaving this place a bit more quiet than it had been before, eh? Hopefully that will give the souls here a bit of comfort. That pretty much all those that were tormenting them, all the ratmen, mistmen, and whatever men, and the keepers, they have all been dispatched. All the servants of these ideal masters have been neutralized. So we assume that, well, their influence here will be lessened. Serves you right, bastards. Alright, let's... Is this where Lady Valerica is? Let's... sì. Oh. No. This is probably not. We are off course again. And then what else is new? Ah, here it is, eh? The most part. All right. Here we are. All right. Lady Valerica is inside now. Oh, there he is. All right. Now, possibly as a favor to Sarada, once we are done with the Harkon, we will return here and inform her mother of this. So we will probably need to come back here. Do so, we will leave Milestone. Eh? Alright, yes. Number... Huh. Yes. Right. So, when we have done with your father, we can return here and recover your mother as well, eh? For now though, let us back to the other milestone that we placed inside the Volkiha ruins. Alright. Yeah, that was convenient, eh? The milestone spell really is very awesome. Alright, let us take this out. Don't need it anymore. And, well... So we should go to the College of Winterhold and inquire there where the next... Well, the other Elder Scroll is, eh? And to do that, we have to teleport again. Alright. Let's toggle the beacon. Alright. This is the last milestone, and we will keep this with us so that we can teleport to the other four. So, this is number one is to the Soul Cairn, to Lady Valerica's residence. This is to the College of Winterhold. This is to Fort Dawnguard. Wait. This is to College Winterhold. This is to High Hrothgar, and this is to Fort Dawnguard. Alright. So the College of Winterhood it is, eh? It's good to be the Archmage and the Master of Magic. Now, we can truly continue our search. Well, after we get ourselves a little rest, eh? Sarada, I think we deserve a bit of time off, don't you think?